Here's the quickest way to do this question. These fractions are all quite close to one. So let's find out, the difference between them and one, and then compare the differences. So 1 minus x is actually just going to be 1 over 111,111. I'll just leave that there for the moment. 1 minus y is going to be 2 over 222,223. And then 1 minus z is 3 over 332,334. So what I can actually do is make the numerators of all of them the same, and I'll just have different denominators, and I'll be able to work out the smallest difference, which one is closest to one. And that would be the biggest. And then the one that's furthest away from one will be the smallest, and so on. So let's times this by top and bottom by six. The common numerator in this case is going to be six. So it's 6 over 666,666. This one here, very similar, but it's going to be 600 and I'm times them through by 3, 669. And here, I'm going to be times them through by 2. So when we divide by a bigger number, the result is going to be smaller. Therefore, this one is the smallest. And therefore, y is going to be the biggest because this will be the closest to one. And then z will be the second biggest because this is the second smallest. And x will be the smallest because it's the furthest away from one. So, really nice way of getting the answer is going to be B. Now, I think I've learned something from this question because I didn't do it like that. But yeah, if you're comparing numbers that are very close to like the same number, then actually look at the differences and it might just work out a lot more, a lot simpler. Okay, I'm going to talk about how I did it. This is method two. So I decided to divide the fractions and see if I get a number bigger than one or smaller than one. So I started with x divided by y. Now, when we divide by y, it's the same as times in by the reciprocal because you keep change flips. I'm just going to go straight into that. And what I noticed is that I have a number on the bottom. Let's use like 111111 as my base. I'm going to call that like A. And the top is actually A minus 1. And then if I double it and minus 1, that will give me this fraction here. Double it and add 1, I'm going to get that one. So it doesn't really matter how big the number is. It's actually a number in this form. I will write down that A is this. Okay, and then let's multiply this out. So I've got a double bracket at the top, 2a squared minus 2a plus a, and then minus 1 all over 2a squared minus a. And we can separate the fractions 2a squared minus a over 2a squared minus a minus 1 over 2a squared minus a. And the reason I've done that is that now I've got 1 minus 1 over 2a squared minus a. A is positive. Remember, I'm not interested in what it is, and that's exactly why I've called it a, because I don't want to be squaring this or anything. I don't want to be actually multiplying them together. But here I don't need to because I can use algebra. But this is necessarily going to be less than 1, which means if I times back through by y, x is less than y. Next up, I'm going to do y divided by z. So again, instead of dividing, I'm going to times by the reciprocal. And I'm going to keep with the a. So now I've got 2a minus 1 over 2a plus 1 times 3a plus 1 over 3a minus 2. Which gives me 6a squared minus 3a plus 2a, so that's a minus a minus 1, all over 6a squared. Then I've got minus 4a plus 3a, so another minus a, but now minus 2. I can write that as 6a squared minus a minus 2, and then add 1. Because that would be the same fraction, and then separate it into two different fractions. Which will be 1 plus 1 over. Now for the a that we have in question, this is definitely going to be greater than 0, which means this is going to be greater than 1, and therefore y is greater than z. So y is bigger than x and y is bigger than z, so we know that y is the biggest, but we still need to compare now x and z. So x over z is our That was our original a minus 1 over a. And I'm going to be times in by 3a plus 1 over 3a minus 2. I can go straight to that. I will write it in. Okay. 3a squared. And I'll get minus 3a plus a, then minus 2a minus 1, all over 3a squared minus 2a. Again. This is going to be less than 1, so x is less than z. Now we have it, x must be the smallest, followed by z, y the biggest. A much more complicated approach, it's got to be said, but hey, it's a second method, that's how I did it. So yeah, I'd be interested to see if there's other methods. Both work well at the end of the day. It's just the first one's the quickest. Hey, well done.